Hello, everybody. Lonnie Laub with Stoller Technologies. Today, we're going to talk about Dell firmware updates. Have you received an email lately about updating your server's firmware, or has it been a couple years since you've actually updated your server's firmware? Why do we need to do that? For security reasons, maybe to get new features? Either way, we get to schedule maintenance windows for our servers to get these updates applied. Today, I'm going to show you how. In order to update the Dell PowerEdge servers, I always like doing it through Dell's Lifecycle Controller. So in order to do that, we're gonna wait for the system to boot and we're gonna hit F10 to jump into that Lifecycle Controller. After we do that, the screen tells us entering Lifecycle Controller. That's how we know it's working. And then we wait again. So you can also update these within your operating system. That's all fine and great. I always like doing it this way because you're not reliant on, there's nothing outside of your control or outside of Dell's control that could cause an issue. This is straight from Dell's system platform and it's a lot more reliable in my opinion. Let me keep waiting. All right, so now we're inside Dell's Lifecycle Controller. The Lifecycle Controller does all sorts of fun things like prep us for an operating system. Actually, we can do hardware diagnostics, change all the settings of the system, but today we're just doing firmware updates. So we're gonna go two down from the top and hit firmware updates. Once we're there, launch firmware update. Okay, so on newer servers, we're gonna select Dell's website. That reaches right out to Dell's download page to pull down the most recent updates from Dell themselves. If you're running an older server, sometimes you'll need to click on network share and then you'll want to select an HTTPS server. With that, Dell's download page should be auto-populated when you select that. And again, that's older servers. If you're using anything 14th generation or above, generally you're safe. So we're gonna do Dell's website, and then we hit next. The next thing it asks for is a proxy. If you're using a proxy at your location, plug all that information in so we can get out to the web and get those updates down. I'm not using one here, so I'm not gonna enter one. Dell flashes up a warning on this and says, are you sure you don't want to enter a proxy? Yes, I'm sure. And then right now it's going down and reaching out to Dell's website, telling it what kind of server we've got, looking for all the updates that are applicable to that server and coming down. One thing, if you don't enter a proxy, Dell will give you an HTTPS certificate error. This is all fine. This is expected. Don't worry about it. Just click yes through that. Okay, so here's all the updates that are applicable to my Dell R730 that I'm working on right now. A DRAC update, I've got diagnostics, I've got network cards, I've got some NVMe drives that don't need updated, and then I've also got a BIOS update. So this should get me all the way up to date with everything that's critical from Dell right now. So all I've got to do, once I've got the items that I want to update selected, I hit apply. And it'll start downloading and installing the updates. This is going to take a minute. All right, so now we've downloaded our updates. Dell's Lifecycle Controller is actually applying these updates. Everything should go through without any issue, and when it's done, generally the system will reboot. There's a couple things though, little gotchas that I want to tell you about. If you've got a failure on either a BIOS update or an iDRAC update, what I recommend doing, apply all the other updates, reboot the system, do the same thing again, only do the BIOS update and let it roll through, and then only do the iDRAC update and let it roll through. Sometimes those have issues. If it's missing like a jump to another revision or something like that, we find it best, if you have that issue, do those updates on their own. And that's it. So now you're updating your server, you've scheduled that maintenance window, everything is rolling through, you guys are gonna be good to go. Updates are no issue to you. If you've got any questions or need anything throughout this process, give us a call here, talk to some of our knowledgeable staff about the products that we've got in stock, or if you have any issues, we've got a great support staff here as well. So you can always trust STI with everything you've got. You got peace of mind free with every server.